I was walking home from school on a cold winter day. Took a shortcut through the woods, and I lost my way. It was getting late, and I was scared and alone. But then a kind old man took my hand and led me home. Now mama couldn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayers. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. When life held troubled times and had me down on my knees, there's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger to lend a helping hand, a phone call from a friend just to say I understand. But ain't it kind of funny, at the dark end of the road, that someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope? Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. They wear so many faces, show up in the strangest places to grace us with their mercy in our time of need. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how, teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love, to guide us with the light of love.
Recently had a service, and the older son said my mother was an angel. And I guess God needed that angel more than we did. It would have been nice if they'd had that song to play at that service. That was beautiful. I want you to know that following Graceside services, you're invited to the care building for having lunch, and know that you want to have time to spend with the family, have time for fellowship, and enjoy a noon meal together. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. And behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also. I don't know if we're living on borrowed time, but we're living on time that God has given us. A time that's in his hands in some ways, but in ours as well. Time to find that he is one who cares about us and loves us, and in a time like this, also wanting to comfort us. It's sometimes good to be honest with God and let him know our feelings. He can read our minds, I suspect, and knows everything about us anyway, but sometimes it's good to say, Lord, I hurt. I have this sorrow, and I miss that loved one, and then that to know the comfort that comes, because God is so willing to comfort. Certainly death does come, but even as Christ was crucified, he was raised from the dead, so therefore there is resurrection. And maybe that's the fulfillment of, because I live, you shall live also, not here on earth. Then we have that opportunity to find that time in heaven. Let us pray. Father, I praise you and thank you, Lord, that you are ever present with us. There are sometimes, Lord, we're hurting and seeming like hurting all over, and sometimes we feel so empty and needing something that would come and fill us up. And when you do that, touching us and blessing us, and we can sense the presence, be it through a guardian angel perhaps sometimes, or maybe it's just a touch of a hand on someone else, and it certainly is that we experience it, Lord, of your comfort that you so willingly provide. And I'm always mindful that Jesus in the Gospel of John, the 14th chapter, said, I will not leave you comfortless, I will come to you. So I pray your blessing upon this family. Touch their hearts and their lives, Lord, and make they sense a fulfillment within them. Bless others of us who come, Lord, with our memories too, and share in this time of remembering Anna. It's time, Lord, we look unto you, but we also want to receive from you. And we know, Lord, that you're willing to bless us. You've done so because of the grace that we find in Jesus Christ. Bless us then, and hear this our prayer, for I ask it in the name of Jesus and for his sake. Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my
Psalmist. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord in all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in the pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. And now shall mine enemies round about me, therefore will I offer up his tabernacle sacrifices and of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord for the way thou handle my enemies. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. When thou saidest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face from me. Put not my servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Another one of the Psalms has these words in them. The Lord has been my dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or even thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and thou sayest, return, ye children of men, for 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday, when it is past and is a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withereth. The days of our years are 80 years and 10, and if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off and we fly away. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. And these are the words that be found in the Gospel of John, Jesus' words. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whither I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? And Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Anna Catherine Johnson, 84, Catholic, Missouri, died Friday, October the 17th, 2003, at the Great River Medical Center in West Burlington, Iowa. She was born April the 5th, 1919, in Joliet, Illinois, a daughter of Frank and Anna Slavosky. She married Lester H. Johnson on June the 2nd, 1940, in Joliet, Illinois. He died on January the 20th, 1996. She was a member of the Catholic Church in Joliet, Illinois. Anne and Lester moved to Clark County in the late 1940s. She had worked at Swift's and then at Shelter Globe in Keokuk, Iowa for 7 years. She was a member of the VFW Ladies Auxiliary in Cahokia, Missouri. Anne enjoyed embroidery and making quilts and rag rugs. She liked doing yard work and canning vegetables from her garden for her family and friends. She was an avid recycler. She loved to cook and loved to dance to polka music. While Lester was alive, they liked to take short drives. Above all else, she loved spending time with her children and grandchildren. Survivors include 4 daughters, Rita Vineyard and her husband George of Burlington, Iowa, Margaret Ann Wade of Clinton, Illinois, Ruth Brotherton, her husband Paul, and Mildred Fogelsong and her husband Michael, all of Cahokia, Missouri. 3 sons, Leroy Johnson and his wife Gloria of Burlington, Iowa, Ray Johnson and his wife Charlotte of Quincy, Illinois, and John Johnson and his wife Deborah of West Burlington, Iowa. 1 stepson, Leonard Johnson, and his wife Ruth of Hamilton, Illinois, and 2 sisters, Margaret Ospa of Kankakee, Illinois, and Mary Miller of Chicago, Illinois. 22 grandchildren, one step-grandchild, 19 great-grandchildren, 5 step-great-grandchildren, several foster grandchildren, and many nieces and nephews. She was also preceded in death by her parents. There are some of you here who would like to share, I know, and this is a good opportunity for you to step forward and do just that.
By now you all know Anne was my sister. I am Margaret. When she was born, she was baptized in the Church of the Lord. And I would like to say a few prayers. And also, we all know the Lord's Prayer. So I would ask all you people to join hands with the partner next to you. You may say your Lord's Prayer. I'll say my, there's a little words difference, but it doesn't make any difference. We all worship the same God. So all right, please. Name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And everybody join in on the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And another thing I want to do before I close, I love greeting cards, and I found something about 20-some years ago, and I give it to my friends, and this is sort of a farewell from her children to her, from her, if I can wipe my eyes. When I am gone, cry for me a while. Think of me, but not too often. It is not good for you, your wife, husband, or children to allow your thoughts to dwell on too long on the dead. Think of me now and again as I was in life, as sometimes which is pleasant to recall, but not too long. Now this is sad. Leave me now in peace, as I have done for you too. While in life, let your thoughts be with the living. That's it. And in memory, I had some of this made up, and I will give that to each one of her children. And if her grandchildren want it, then they can make copies. Thank you.
For those of you that don't know me, I'm Anita, Mildred's youngest daughter, and I've been kind of nominated to read a few things from some of my cousins and my mom. This is from Cindy Johnson, dedicated to her father, Johnny Johnson, in memory of Anna C. Johnson. It's titled, Dancing Among the Polka Angels. Here you were, in pain, suffering so, death at your door, then God reached for you, calling your name, Anna, taking you to his home. Now no more pain, no more suffering. Now you are dancing amongst his polka angels, floating through the air, your steps light, breathing freely at last. You were loved, extremely missed by all of us honored, loved by your presence, your time spent here on earth. None more honored than I, for I carry with me more than just part of you in my heart, mind, spirit. I carry your name within mine. I am your baby boy. I am your son, Johnny Johnson. My dearest, sweet mother, I shall love you always, but you shall remain locked within me, my memories. I carry you, your love for me, my love for you within my heart, that special place within a child that only a mother could fill. That place, Mama, I hold you dearly within me, never letting you go. In loving memory of Anna Catherine Johnson, born April 5th, 1919, passed away October 17th, 2003. Don't grieve for me, for now I'm free. I'm following the path God has laid, you see. I took his hand when I heard him call. I turned my back and left it all. I could not stay another day to laugh, to love, to work or play. Tasks left undone must stay that way. I found that peace at the close of the day. If my parting has left a void, then fill it with remembered joys, a friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss. Oh yes, these things I too will miss. Be not burdened with times of sorrow. I wish you the sunshine of tomorrow. My life's been full, I'm savored such. Good friends, good times, a loved one's touch. Perhaps my time seemed all too brief, but don't lengthen it now with undue grief. Lift up your hearts and peace to thee. God wanted me now, he set me free. This poem has been dedicated with much love to the memory of Anna Catherine Johnson, friend, sister, aunt, wife, mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother. She will be greatly missed, one by all. That was from Dina. My mom, Anna Catherine Johnson. As I was growing up, my mom taught me many things: washing clothes, ironing, cleaning house, baking, canning, sewing. This was what she always said a young girl should know. She always said that you should have a little money set aside in case of emergencies. And those who knew her, they knew she always did. You could always find money somewhere. When I was growing up, Mom always was there for me, no matter if we were working in the garden, mowing the yard, or doing chores. She would go to town with us kids a lot of time just to be with us. When my brother John and I were little, Mom always took us to meet Dad. This was when he was working on the boat. We would ride the train to Joliet when he would stop off there. Mom raised us kids while Dad was gone, but when Dad came home on leave, you could tell she was really happy to have everybody at home. Through the years, Mom worked on rug rags, quilts, and baby blankets. She has given something to all of her kids and grandkids. She was always happy to help other people, and she never wanted anything in return. She enjoyed watching and playing with her many grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and foster grandchildren. Mom's favorite music was polka music, and she used to love to watch the Lawrence Welk show. Mom always danced the polka with me, John, and Rita at all the families, at all of our weddings that our families had. This is a tradition that will be hard to continue without her, but I know she will be dancing with us in heaven and in our hearts. She also liked to go to Mount Pleasant, to the Old Thrashers, and to all the local country music shows. Mom is in heaven now with Dad. I am sure they are catching up on everything that has been happening while they listen to their polka. They say angels get their wings when they accomplish their goals. My mom got her angel wings a long time ago. My mom was a sweet, kind, loving person. She worked hard to do things for her family and friends. That was just my mom. Mom, you will be missed, but you gave us all much to be thankful for, and the memories we will always have. Rest in peace, your youngest daughter, Mildred Eileen. And then I got this poem as an email when Grandma got really sick. Not this last time that she went into the hospital, but the time before that in the nursing home. And I saved it because I just thought it was something that, even if you haven't had a loved one close to you pass away, I think it's something that everybody needs to think about the real meaning in. Maybe possibly just go out and tell the people how you feel. It's called Around the Corner. Around the corner, I have a friend in this great city that has no end. Yet the days go by and weeks rush on, and before I know it, a year is gone. And I never see my old friend's face, for life is a swift and terrible race. She knows I like her just as well as in the days when I rang her bell. And she rang mine, but we were much younger then. And now we are busy, tired women. Tired of playing a foolish game, tired of trying to make a name. Tomorrow, I say, I will call on Grandma, just to show that I'm thinking of her. But tomorrow comes and tomorrow goes, and around the corner, yet miles away, there's a telegram. Grandma passed away today. And that's what we get and deserve in the end. Around the corner, a vanished friend. Remember to always say what you mean. If you love someone, tell them. Don't be afraid to express yourself. Reach out and tell somebody what they mean to you. Remember when you decide that it is the right time, it might be too late. Seize the day, never have regrets. And most importantly, stay close to your friends and family, for they helped make you the person that you are today.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the Oh.
beautiful rendition of In the Garden. Wow. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, from the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. What a beautiful picture of heaven. God created. In the beginning, God. That's how the Bible begins. In the beginning, God. And recognizing there was nothing existing, nothing more than just God in the beginning. And God created, and I don't know if these are words of a song or not, but it seems to me like it's a part of a song anyway. God created all things beautiful. God made all things beautiful. Certainly true. Made all things beautiful. His creation is so good. We in our church in Clarence begin the service that way. God is good, and the people respond all the time. And my response is all the time, and they said, God is good. And that did not come from here in a sense. However, there was a lady who used to attend the church, and when she left the service, she would say, God is good. When I had her funeral service and I said, God is good, and the family back there said all the time, and it kind of caught on with me. We're not originators of that. It's been in other places too, but that is the truth of it, isn't it? God is good all the time. God is always working his goodness. I've seen his goodness this morning. I've seen his goodness in the last few minutes, obviously, the goodness that's in a family. The goodness that comes because of love. That is the love of God that comes. Herein is the love that God first loved us. Somehow he's kind of been teaching us about love, hasn't he? The love that can be shared, and the love that's shared with one with another. A love so important for each of us. A love that we so desire. Love, perhaps compassion also, is that we can see of God's goodness. Pretty close together, isn't it, love and compassion? But among that is certainly understanding. God is understanding, giving us understanding too, and understanding what people can experience. Maybe not walking in their shoes, but still having a sense of what they experience and understanding it. One of the things I appreciate is to find those of you who have hope. God has given you hope. We have that hope of heaven, don't we? It's more than just saying a hope. It's a promise of heaven, a promise that comes through Christ. Another one of those attributes, and maybe it's a characteristic of people who have that love within them, that is encouragement. Those who are encouragers are such a blessing, giving encouragement to others. And maybe that encouragement is also to say comfort, too, and being able to have understanding, giving hope, but in encouragement with a comforting kind of blessed kind of way. So I kind of go back and sensing that God in the beginning was good in his creation. He said that, and as he created day by day, saying each day was good, and God is good. His goodness also to be seen in families, the goodness of God in this family. We saw Anna and her goodness too, didn't we? The goodness has been expressed in different ways, most certainly through friendliness. I know that she had good days and lots of good days, and some of those good days were certainly with Lester, and or those traveling over the countryside and what they were seeing and seeing visible the goodness of God in their travels around to different places. I know they sense that goodness together, and they found with others in the company they would have with others, not just family, but others in the community. And some of that might have been in a dinner in a certain area of Clark County, going to a dinner there. It must be in that goodness that we could see in that of her work. And I didn't see her handiwork. I have to admit that in days gone by. And to know that, and that was a part of her life, it was good to know the goodness that was established or created in what she could do in her creation. And I most certainly never did see her dance the polka. And that must have been something, it was a goodness part of her life too, and who's picking up the trend? Which one of you? Oh, Rita's going to carry on the tradition then. Okay. It must have been that she put a lot into life, but she also got a lot out of life. And we certainly could say, can't we, that God is so good, God and his goodness displayed in her life. Well, the goodness that we can find of God, the glory that we can find to God is knowing that he is present with us, and the glory that comes for us is that he came in Jesus, seeing at a time when mankind was lost in darkness, falling away from God, straying so far away that he sent Jesus, or he came in the place of Jesus, came as a man, and lived, was crucified for our sin, that in Christ that we can find even that of eternal life. Recognizing the goodness of God and dying for our sin is that most comforting too. But we know that he was crucified, but he also arose from the dead. He is alive, and he ascended into heaven. He went into heaven to sit at the right hand of God, his rightful place, the right hand of his Father. And God was so good, in the goodness of loving us through his Son Jesus, his only begotten Son, that we would believe in him would not perish but have everlasting life. Jesus went on to heaven. He went on there to prepare a place for us, that where he is, there we may be also, as the Gospel of John said. There, waiting for us. Waiting for us. A time that preparing for us, a time that's being made ready for us, a time for the people of God, a time for the people who love Jesus. Heaven, well, yes, another song could say how beautiful heaven must be, and surely it must be, how beautiful heaven must be. I remember a lady who was up in the years. Her husband had passed away, and when she went up to the casket at the end of the service, she said, farewell. I'm not going to say goodbye. I'm going to say farewell, because I'm looking for that time of seeing you again. And that's kind of where we are, aren't we? We say farewell to Anna, knowing, looking forward to, as already brought forth, you want to see Lester and maybe a sister's husband too there. Well, we have that hope. We have that dream. We have that promise that one day heaven's for us. One day heaven for us. God is so good. God created the best place of all. As good as earth is and as good as this life is, heaven is best of all. I know you've heard the story too. That's one of those email things that kind of gets around quite a bit anymore too, is that fork. And a person who had passed away, or was going to pass away, I guess I actually did, but said before, I want you to put a fork in my casket. Why would you want us to do that? Because when I go to those dinners and I get done to the end of my meal and they come to pick up my plate, they say, maybe you want to keep your fork, for the best is yet to come. Well, heaven is best yet to come, and heaven awaits us all. God is so good, and his goodness displayed in that of his love, the love that he has for us. Let us pray. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you are ever present with us. I like those words, you'll never leave us nor forsake us. There's that you do in our lives and fulfilling our prayers. Sometimes we sense it is a prayer that we lifted and a prayer that's answered, and a blessing that comes our way because of your faithfulness to us, your goodness to us. And I pray these who are here, Anna's family, her loved ones, her neighbors, her friends, we'll sense that blessing upon their lives today, but we need that blessing tomorrow. However many days we have ahead of us, Lord, may it be that we'll walk in faith, walking in the peace that is of God, walking in the promise of God, walking towards heaven. Bless, I pray, and hear our prayers, for I lift all these things in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. Roll on.
Bob's on the run. Sing Boone Herrera. Ring out a song of good cheer. Now's the time to roll the barrel, for the gang's all here. Song of the cheer.